met you on your 21st birthday 6.5 years ago, I knew that this was something special. The instant connection we had was not of this world. And although we were standing in your unromantic, cold, run-down fraternity house, I knew that God had his hand in this. Thank you for loving me the way you do. You and I have similar outlooks on life, and always talk about how we want to get married, have a couple, hopefully 3 kids, and live a simple life in Orange County. And here we are making our dreams come true. It's no secret that marriages are hard, but I believe that marriage is about making choices. It's a choice to sit and communicate with your partner, a choice to stay in a relationship even in a hard time, and a choice to see the good in a beautiful commitment made between two people in love. So today, I am choosing to love you for the rest of my day. I choose to try my best to have everything in perfect order so your OCD self doesn't have to fix it twice.
Got that from him.
Got that from his dad. To be there at the end of the day with a hug and a listening ear, to mirror the patience that you show me every day, and to always communicate like we do best. I choose to be a wife who nurtures and invests in our relationship. I choose to be Elliot Neville.
Melanie, I can't believe 6.5 years have now passed since we first met. 6.5 years since I saw that perfect, tiny little woman wearing that bright pink dress. There are differing opinions and recollections of who started talking to who first the day we met, as well as when the conversation began exactly, my memory being the correct one, of course. But I think we can agree it was at a Super Bowl party in 2016 that happened to fall on my 20th birthday. I got your phone number that day we met. I didn't know if everyone caught that. Every day together with you since has instilled the feeling in me even stronger that what I want is you, only you, all of you, every day for the remainder of my life. You bring out the best version of me because looking at you makes me want to be the best man I can possibly be. You amaze me constantly with your commitment to your incredible family, your love for your friends, and your God-given gift to be absolutely incredible with children, as I know you will be with ours one day. It's difficult to put into words how blessed I feel to get to be the man to share his life with you. I get to be alongside you for everything, and it is the single best part of my life. I vow to you to never take that for granted. I vow to you to try to treat every date night like a first date when I don't know if there will be a second. I vow to you to be interested in and curious about you, your thoughts, your feelings when we're 72, the same way I did when we were 22, because I never want to stop learning about you and learning from you. The future ahead of us is so bright. When I think about what's to come, everything else seems so unimportant compared to the life we will build and the family we will have. We both have seen in our own families the difficulties of marriage and how trying it can be. Marriages are long, and even the best ones have their ups and downs. I vow to you in those more difficult of times to still hold you, support you, and love you just the same, and to never forget the bigger picture. I vow to you in the difficult times to always go back to that I won the lottery type of feeling I had when you returned my text right away the day after I met you. That lottery winning feeling is overwhelming today looking at you in that white dress. It was a truly special feeling when I started being able to call you my girlfriend, Even better to have the exciting grown-up feeling of having a fiance, but excited to look at you forever and be able to say, that's my wife. I love you more than anything in the world, Melanie.
But I don't believe a word, and I try to sabotage it, but when you're gone it hurts. And I used to get cold feet. I never go too deep. I'm scared of the sound of a heartbeat, but it's undeniable what I feel for you. You know I've been wrong before, but you're go too deep. I'm scared of